And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary and the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. The Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest,
and
on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who were pleased to call your church the bride, grant that the people that serve your name may revere you, love you, and follow you, and may be led by you to attain your promises in heaven. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. The angel brought me back to the entrance of the temple, and I saw water flowing out from beneath the threshold of the temple toward the east. For the facade of the temple was toward the east. The water flowed down from the southern side of the temple, south of the altar. He led me outside by the north gate and around to the outer gate facing the east, where I saw water trickling from the southern side. He said to me, "This water flows into the eastern district from down upon the Arabah and empties into the sea, the salt waters which it makes fresh. Wherever the river flows, every sort of living creature that can multiply shall live, and there shall be abundant fish. For wherever this water comes, the sea shall be made fresh. Along both banks of the river, fruit trees of every kind shall grow. Their leaves shall not fade, nor their fruit fail. Every month they shall bear fresh fruit, for they shall be watered by the flow from the sanctuary. Their fruit shall serve for food, and their leaves for medicine." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The waters of the river gladdens the city of God, the holy dwelling of the Most High.
The waters of the river gladden the city of God, the holy dwelling of the Most High.
God is our refuge and our strength, an ever-present help in distress. Therefore, we fear not, though the earth be shaken, and mountains plunge into the depths of the sea.
The waters of the river gladden the city of God, the holy dwelling place of the Most High.
There is a stream whose runlets gladden the city of God, the holy dwelling of the Most High. God is in its midst. It shall not be disturbed. God will help it at the break of dawn.
The waters of the river gladden the city of God, the holy dwelling of the Most High.
The Lord of hosts is with us. Our stronghold is the God of Jacob. Come, behold the deeds of the Lord, the astounding things he has wrought on earth.
The waters of the river gladden the city of God, the holy dwelling of the Most High.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, you are God's building, according to the grace of God given to me. Like a wise master builder, I laid a foundation, and another is building upon it. But each one must be careful how he builds upon it. For no one can lay a foundation other than the one that is there, namely Jesus Christ. Do you not know that you are the temple of God, and that the Spirit of God dwells in you? If anyone destroys God's temple, God will destroy that person, for the temple of God, which you are, is holy. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia. 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 I have chosen and consecrated this house, says the Lord, that my name may be there forever. Alleluia. 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 The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Since the Passover of the Jews was near, Jesus went up to Jerusalem. He found in the temple area those who sold oxen, sheep, and doves, as well as the money changers seated there. He made a whip out of cords and drove them all out of the temple area with the sheep and oxen, and spilled the coins of the money changers and overturned their tables. To those who sold doves, he said, take these out of here and stop making my father's house a marketplace. His disciples recalled the words of scripture, zeal for your house will consume me. At this, the Jews answered and said to him, what sign can you show us for doing this? Jesus answered and said to them, destroy this temple, and in 3 days I will raise it up. The Jews said, this temple has been under construction for 46 years, and you will raise it up in 3 days. But he was speaking about the temple of his body. Therefore, when he was raised from the dead, his disciples remembered that he had said this, and they came to believe the scripture and the word that Jesus had spoken. Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear friends, today our Mass intention is for our protection and safety as the storm Ada continues to pass us by and leaving the remnants of its wind and rain affecting us. So for our protection and safety, we pray this day. Today is a feast, not of a person, but of a place. Today is the feast of the anniversary of the dedication of the Basilica of St. John Lateran. The Basilica, one of the major basilicas in the city of Rome, was dedicated in the year 324 AD, and it is the cathedral for the Bishop of Rome, the Pope, not as famous or well known as St. Peter's of the Vatican, but in fact, it is indeed preeminent as the cathedral for the Bishop of Rome, and it is regarded as the mother and head of all the churches of the world, St. John Lateran. It was the residence of the Pope from the 4th century to the 14th century. It's the site of 5 ecumenical councils. And beneath its high altar is a small wooden table on which, according to tradition, St. Peter himself celebrated. Over the centuries, fires and earthquakes have repeatedly destroyed the structure, and each time it has been rebuilt. It is built in the form of a cross, reminding us of the words of Jesus that discipleship requires that we each take up our own cross and follow it. For this feast, on our first reading, we have the prophet Ezekiel describing a vision of the temple. And from that temple flows life-giving water. Water so life-giving that it flows into the Dead Sea, which he calls the Araba, and causes the Dead Sea to teem with life. In the Gospel, Jesus describes his body as a temple and makes reference to his death and his resurrection, saying, "Destroy this temple, and in 3 days I will raise it up." St. Paul, in our second reading for this feast day, takes up this image, and he reminds us of who we are. "Do you not know," he says, "that you are the temple of God, and that the Spirit of God dwells in you?" Now, that is a thought we can dwell on at least for the rest of this day. Do you not know that you are the temple of God and the Spirit of God dwells in you? Of course, friends, November is our month of remembering, and so today we continue to remember deceased loved ones, whether they died 25 years ago or 10 years ago or last month or last week or just yesterday. They remain a part of our lives. We remember them and we pray that they rest in the joy of God's presence. Our prayer for them. Lord, for those who believe in you, death is the end of poverty and the beginning of riches. The end of pain and the beginning of joy. The end of weakness and the beginning of strength. Do not let grief overwhelm us or loss embitter us. But out of our sadness, let our joy arise, for so much given to us. Cast out our fears and do not let our hearts be troubled or afraid. In love and trust, we commend to you our deceased loved ones whom we remember at this time, those whom you have called out of this mortal life. You love them with great love, now that they are freed from all the sorrows of this earth. Admit them to your presence, where mourning and sadness are no more, but peace and joy in the presence of your Son, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. Eternal rest run unto them, O Lord.
And let perpetual light shine upon them.
May their souls and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace.
Amen.
Amen. And now let us put our needs before the Lord, as is our custom at this time. We pray first for the church throughout the world, that it continue to be that community of disciples committed to bearing their cross and being examples of the loving presence of the Lord in this world, for this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for Francis, our Pope, that he may continue to have the courage and the strength to lead us after the manner of Christ, the Good Shepherd, for this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for our continued protection as this hurricane, this storm, Ada, continues to pass us by, for this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all of those who are recovering from COVID-19, particularly those who, having completed their quarantine, still have lingering symptoms and may be frightened or afraid or uncertain. For them, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all those who have died recently, that the Lord may draw them to himself. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us now in silence put before the Lord whatever needs may most heavily upon each of our hearts this day. For all these things we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Good and gracious God, grace us always with the joy of your presence, of your nearness. Grace us always with the courage to live as your disciples. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you from the earth and work of human hands, and become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you from the vine and work of human hands, and become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
The humble spirits and contrite heart be accepted by you, O Lord, may our sacrifices to be pleasing to you. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the Lord, his Holy Church.
Accept, we pray, O Lord, the offerings made here, and grant that by those who seek your favor, grant that by it those who seek your favor may receive in this place the power of the sacraments and the answer to their prayers through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Eternal God. For in your benevolence, you are pleased to dwell in this house of prayer in order to perfect us as the temple of your Holy Spirit. Supported by the perpetual help of your grace and the splendid and glory of a life acceptable to you. Year by year, you sanctify the church, the bride of Christ, foreshadowed in visible buildings, so that rejoicing as mother of countless children, she may be given her place in your heavenly glory. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you, and without end, we acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving thanks, he said the blessing and broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to a second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with all the saints, with all those whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, dear servant Francis, our Pope, and me, our unworthy servant, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters and to all who are pleasing to you on their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom we bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Now we make our act of spiritual communion at this time. By Jesus, I believe that you are really present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I hunger to receive you. Since I cannot receive communion at this moment, feed my soul with me spiritually. I unite myself wholly to you now as I do when I actually receive you. Permit me never to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who chose to foreshadow for us the heavenly Jerusalem through the sign of your church on earth, grant we pray that by our partaking of this sacrament we may be made the temple of your grace and may enter the dwelling place of your glory through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Now and forever.
Our help is in the name of the Lord.
Who made heaven and earth.
The Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us go in peace.